Okay, so this is a video that a lot of my YouTube followers and the honeybee enthusiasts have been asking for a long time. And we're going to do a sea salt comparison to see what the honeybees prefer when we mix it with water so that they can get the benefits of all these fantastic minerals. And I'm introducing the sea salts here first. Celtic sea salt, I have to say, has the most elaborate packaging and the most extensive claims to the health and nutritional benefits of any of the sea salts that I'm testing here today. The nutrition facts, they also say it's non-GMO. When it comes to minerals, I don't know how you genetically modify them, but maybe somebody else knows better. Sea salts are sodium, and we also have Morton Natural Sea Salts. It's another one that I grabbed. And just like it says here on the box, it's for all cooking. Now, all the salts that we're using are suitable for human consumption. So I'm guessing that they're good for the bees. The reason that we're on this in the first place is because the bees showed a preference for water that had salt content over regular, pure, filtered water. And again, the nutritional facts here for the Morton salt. And this comes from the Bahamas. So these are, you know, distilled from natural seawater. It's dehydrated down until we have the salts and minerals left over. And I'm just giving you a brief look at each of the packages so that you'll kind of know what they look like, where they came from, who's making them and providing them. So we're out here by my pond, and here's the one, Pure Himalayan Pink Crystal Salt. 84 minerals. So we know that the bees need minerals and salts and that they need all these things and they find them in the environment. Where they find them, I don't know. But we're going to make it easy for them to get at this in solution. So these are finely ground sea salts, and all of these I purchased from Amazon. And I'll give you the links so that you can look at them, read reviews. Of course, reviews are based on human consumption and what it tasted like. This pink Himalayan sea salt, some people even question whether or not it has some sugar added or something, but that is not in the ingredients. It just apparently has a really good flavor. So again, the labeling on the back here, and it even has a shelf life, 2023, and then of course the nutritional facts. So these are packaged nice and fancy. Don't forget, you always have to keep pure filtered fresh water that's free of anything, and that's what these feeders have in them. So aside from the sea salts, we're going to have filtered water available as always in the bee yard. Here's how we've laid it out. As always, based on my past testing, we have 4 1-quart containers. They started off with fresh, pure, filtered water, and the water source is well water, and the filter system is PUR, which was the highest filtering medium that I could find for, again, intended for people to drink. So the bees showed a preference for that in the past. That's our baseline. The reason that the water is a little colored here is because this time I added 2 drops of green food coloring per quart so that we could see the levels better. And the bees are going after these sea salts right away. And as you can see, they actually prefer this over fresh water that does not have the high mineral content. Now, we arrived at the 1 teaspoon per quart based on my last experience, which was done with just table salt. And we added different amounts of table salt per quart, and the bees preferred the 1 teaspoon per quart of salts over other content levels. So here the bees are just going after everything here. And you might be surprised at these end results as to what the bees show a preference for, but I will say, overall, the preference of the honeybees is to go after water that has mineral content. This is number one. They chose Morton Sea Salts over the others. And number two in the lineup is the most popular crystal sea salt, Himalayan Pink Crystal. And this is the one that everyone has been asking me to try out with the bees, so I did. Number three in the lineup is 1 teaspoon per quart of Celtic sea salts. That was the most expensive, by the way. And of course, last on the list, no big surprise, 1 teaspoon per quart of STONEMILL iodized table salt. This is regular table salt that most people put on their table. There are extensive benefits claimed regarding the sea salts over table salt. The bees really don't show a huge preference of any of these over the other, because you can see the levels here now. The duration of this test was actually 4 days, And 1 teaspoon per quart of Morton Sea Salt was preferred, but look, across the board, it's not like they chose it 2-to-1. The bees are going to go after water that has mineral content, and they need it, and they use it. And there's some discussion about how the bees might be using mineralized water as part of their dehydration process inside the hive when they're dehydrating honey and nectar. That does not mean that they're putting these sea salts into the honey and nectar cells. They're using it as a cooling process, but of course for health and nutrition and well-being of the bees themselves, having access to minerals is going to benefit them. And they definitely, if we're looking to the bees for guidelines on what's good for them, if we're making all these options available, they're telling us pretty conspicuously that they want water with minerals in it. And again, if nothing else is available, of course, you're going to take that iodized table salt, but it is their last of the 4 tested sea salts here. And here we have it. So that's the summary. Just closing out with a slow motion look here of my landing board. We have a lot going in the bee yard right now. We just installed the Flow Hive 2, and I put it in the bee yard without anything except Swarm Commander. I'm trying to find out if a swarm of bees is going to home in there and just take it over. And just before I started editing this video, I was out in the apiary, and there are guard bees and scouts already checking out the Flow Hive 2. It has no resources in it. It only has acorn waxed frames in it. And of course, the Flow Hive frames, it's going to be interesting to share with you how that goes. I'd like to attract a swarm to it without doing any honeybee install at all. So look for that in upcoming videos. It's going to be interesting, I promise. They are actually setting up shop. The scout bees are even guarding the empty hive, so I think they're acting as placeholders. Keep watching. Thanks for watching this video, and I hope you found the information helpful. Thanks for watching.